This photo is now about 55 years old. It's a picture from the summer of 1962, when I was simply an undergraduate who had the wonderful opportunity of working in the laboratory of Jim Watson, who, after he and Francis Crick solved the structure of DNA, was a faculty member at Harvard. And each summer, the laboratory climbed upon one of the two bronze rhinoceroses in front of Harvard's bio labs. I am in the back of the rhinoceros, behind Watson, who was seated behind Wally Gilbert, who received the Nobel Prize for working out a method to sequence DNA. Amongst the other people there was my immediate supervisor, then a graduate student, Mario Capecchi, who also won the Nobel Prize for his development of methods to knock out genes in mammals. These were exciting times for a young 18-year-old, and certainly have taught me the importance of working intensely on a really fundamental problem, because these are the problems that give you the greatest payoff. I've been here now 50 years, from the days I was a medical student to a graduate student, and moved up through the ladder. And the areas that we worked on, how cells destroy proteins, has gone from being a peripheral activity that few people were interested in to a central problem in biology. A small biotech company that I co-founded was able to develop a drug, the proteasome inhibitor Velcade, that has now been used in treating almost 500,000 people who have suffered from multiple myeloma. This has been truly a rewarding experience, especially because the exact value of the basic research we've done could not have been predicted. This picture also reminds me of how science has progressed so dramatically. In those days, messenger RNA had just been discovered. To young scientists, I would think this would be the most exciting of times, because they are empowered by new tools to approach so many issues that we couldn't imagine would be dissected by scientists in our lifetimes.